In this video, we're going to be comparing Bubble versus Bildr. What is Bubble? Bubble is a platform where you can create digital products without code. What is Bildr? Bildr is a platform where you can create web apps, websites, Google Chrome extensions, and the list goes on and on. What's the difference? Bubble is a platform that has been around for a few years, and it's more mature. It has a really vibrant community, and you can use plugins. You can do all kinds of things on this platform. What also I would mention is it has a very specific type of workflow that allows you to create your projects. So there is a learning curve when you're in Bubble. You're going to have to understand the database, the workflow, what you need to do, the actions, and all of those things. But you can create an abundance of different kind of projects with Bubble. Bildr, on the other hand, you can do a lot. But what I would say is what I've seen in the time that I've spent on this and talking to ones, it really helps if you have a background, if you've done something with coding or familiar with CSS or those kind of things, because the structure of this platform is it's very familiar to coders, to developers when they go in here. What's the best case scenario? Why should you go one over the other? This really just depends on your own case and what you're trying to do. And then also keep in mind, it's not a one for one. Bubble has been around a lot longer than Bildr. So at this point, you can't just say like, I want to just choose one or the other. It just depends on where you're at and what you want to do. Bubble already has the community and has all of these different plugins and very specific use cases that the community helps each other out. You have that. And then you have boot camps and all these things around Bubble. I know I struggle with the format of Bubble and just the structure of what I'm going to be doing visually. I've had a struggle with that with Bubble. There's tons of different companies that have boot camps and teach you the logistics and the workflow, how you can optimize Bubble and the relationship with the different landing pages, the different mobile views, all of those things, how it can be responsive. You still have to learn those things, and that is specific to Bubble. Once you have it, you can go off to the races, and there's a lot of different examples. If you go look at Stephen Campbell's work, Dan Perry, the list goes on and on. People can make Bubble look good, but you still have to understand how to do it. Versus on Bildr, when I'm working on different projects, I'm going to already have the framework of a landing page. Now, again, on the flip side, Bildr might be something for ones that are already developers and you don't want to do certain things. Like, say, for instance, if you're already, you just don't want to be a visual composer. You're not wanting to style a certain thing in CSS and you just want it to be easier. Bildr, I think, is a great way, or that in between where you can create things really quickly based on the principles that you already have. Again, it depends on where you are in your journey, your background, what's going on, what you're trying to create, and going from there. And I'm very excited about Bildr and all the different capabilities and the different templates that they plan to build in the future. We'll have to wait and see what's going on with that. Keep in mind, it's not going to be as mature. They're not going to have the same robust community or plugins or all of those things like Bubble. Bubble has had years to be able to develop that with the community. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you in the next video.